We said research is formed from the two words re and search. That means once again searching the phenomena around, the social happenings around. Depending on the purpose, the point of view from which the researches are conducted, there are many types of classification of researches. Today we will be seeing the classification based on the purpose of the research. There are three main types of the researches. They are called as pure, applied and action researches. Let us see few examples of the questions that the researchers would like to answer. Something like, why did the universe take birth? Then maybe some psychological theory, maybe a theory of multiple intelligence. Maybe the question like, what are the protons, neutrons are composed of? When such type of questions are addressed, which may or may not have the immediate application into the daily life, they are called as pure researches. In case of pure researches, the researches are conducted for the knowledge. So it is the knowledge for the knowledge sake. The question of whether it has the immediate utility or otherwise is not asked and is not in the focus by the researchers. These kind of researches are basically conducted for development of principles, development of theories. The researchers here get the intellectual pleasure of learning something new. These are the kind of researches where the researcher has more control over the conditions around. That is why these are conducted more in the artificial situations or in the laboratories. They are of exploratory in nature. There is no pre-assumption as far as the utility is concerned. The force that drives the researcher to take up a pure research is the pursuit for knowledge and the curiosity for answering the questions. These researches are not for creating something new or does not have any planned applications of the researches. And that is why there are no commercial values immediately attached to the research. Maybe when the research is conducted, that time there are no immediate applications of that principles or the theories that are developed. But maybe over a period of time, in the longer duration, these theories find an important place in the social interactions or even in the scientific studies. Thus, the main motivation of these kind of researches is development of knowledge, principles and theories. It is the intellectual pursuit of the researchers that makes researcher to take up these kind of researches. These researchers also sometimes study the relationship between the variables theoretically. These researches are mainly concerned with the development of social theories, the development of the scientific theories and principles. They help in supporting or rejecting the presently existing theories and hypotheses. These kind of researches, though may not have the immediate application, in the due course of time, they give rise to the applied researches. A few more examples of these could be Piaget's theory of cognitive development, Pavlov's classical conditioning theory, maybe a study of specific genetic code of a fruit fly. So such kind of researches, they are basically taken up for the pursuit of knowledge, and that is why they are called as the pure researches. Let us take up an example of research where a researcher is trying to study a computer-based package for algebra teaching, or maybe a research that is dealing with the cost-benefit analysis, or maybe accommodation of various learning styles into a single lesson plan. Such kind of researches where the existing theory are tested for their applications in the daily life, they are called as the applied researches. This definition goes as, applied research refers to scientific study and research that seeks to solve practical everyday problems, cure illness, and develop innovative technologies rather than to acquire knowledge for the knowledge's sake. As the definition implies, here the knowledge is generated for the utility aspect and not only for the knowledge's sake as it was the case in the pure researches. So here how the theories, the principles are used for making the life comfortable, for making the progress in the society. That is the focus in case of applied researches. In case of applied researches, it has the implications directly for the practitioners in the society, so that they can make the products that are useful for making the life easier. One of the silent features of applied researches is it is same in rigor as that of the pure research. That means it has objectives, it will have the data collection procedures as well as the data analysis. The only difference as compared to the pure researches is, in case of pure researches, the environment, the atmosphere is very sterile or a laboratory kind of a situation. Whereas in case of applied researches, the researches are conducted in the actual daily situations. Because of this, the researcher has little less control over the factors that are affecting on the research. These kind of researches can be exploratory, but many of the times they are of descriptive in nature. It involves precise measurements of various characteristics, and it describes relationship between the various variables that are involved in the social phenomena. The collection and analysis of data is with the purpose of checking the utility of a theory into the daily practice. Applied researches are taken up with the aim of solving specific problems. They also have the utility of making some policy decisions for betterment of social life. The focus here is solving the specific and practical problems from the daily life. We'll see a few more examples of applied researches. They could be developing a better crop type which gives the better yield, or maybe finding out a medicine to cure a particular disease. It could be also researching about a particular teaching method which has the best suitability in the classroom situation. It could be developing social science curriculum for the standard 7 students in order to develop their problem solving ability. So thus, as compared to the pure research, the applied research comes more closer to the life and more utility for the life. We go to the third type now, that is called as the action research. In order to understand the concept of action research, let us see a few examples. Training effective writers of business English through interactive feedback. Or another example is study of effectiveness of the action plan prepared for problems faced by tribal students in learning of Marathi. We'll go for one more. Study of the effectiveness of the action plan prepared for the problems faced by standard 9 students in the study of graphs. Now, when we see these three examples, one can note that they are very, very specific to the group, very, very specific to the person who is actually in the field, who is actually at the grassroots level. Such kind of researches which are conducted by the practitioners in order to solve their own problems for their limited group with whom they are working, they are called as the action research. As the terminology speaks about the two words, there is action involved which is by the practitioner himself, and there is a component of research also attached to that action. The definition of action research is given as a participatory democratic process concerned with developing practical knowing in the pursuit of worthwhile human purposes, grounded in the participatory worldview which we believe is emerging at this historical moment. We will see one more definition of action research. Action research is simply a form of self-reflective inquiry undertaken by participants in social situations in order to improve the rationality and justice of their own practices, their understanding of these practices, and the situations in which the practices are carried out. So, as you see from the definitions, these are the researches conducted by the practitioners in order to improve their own practices, in order to improve their understanding of the social group with whom they are working. In case of situations related to the education, the definition can go as inquiry-based research conducted by teachers that follows the process of examining existing practices, implementing new practices, and evaluating the results, leading to an improvement cycle that benefits both students and teachers. As the definition says, it is not only focused towards the students, but it is also focused towards the researcher himself who is performing the role of a teacher. So here the teacher's own reflections come into picture, and his own way of handling the students, his way of teaching in the class, that also comes into the focus. Earlier, when the researchers were conducting researches, they were mainly following the first two types, that is the pure and the applied researches. It was the Kurt Lewin and then eventually Stephen Corey who said that the practitioners also need to conduct researches in order to improve their own practice. So, unlike the pure and applied researches where the focus is maybe a wider society, in case of action research, the focus is only my work, my situation, my group, maybe my students, my problem, and hence it is my solution to that problem. So here the generalization is not expected and is not possible. The researcher, that is the practitioner, conducts a research or adopts a modality which is different than the current practice and checks its utility for solving the immediate problem at hand. Thus, the solution which is suitable for one practitioner may or may not be suitable for the other practitioner. Thus, in case of action research, it brings together the action as well as the reflection part, and thus gives an opportunity for the practitioners to conduct the researches for improvement of their own practices. Since these researches are conducted into the actual social settings, the researcher has further less control over the various factors that are affecting the social phenomena. It is a process of studying the practical problems in the social settings. In this case, the practitioner only can take up such kind of researches because the extent to which he or she will be aware of the deep root problems, nobody else would be aware of that. So this is a very much a personal research for a practitioner. The findings from the action research, they do not contribute to the fund of knowledge in the discipline. The utility is very, very specific, limited to the that particular practitioner himself. We will see a few more examples of the action researches using interactive multimedia to support information systems training, system design and learning issues. Another example could be lecturing initiatives with multimedia tools in engineering education. We'll go for one more example. Study of effectiveness of the action plan developed for the rectification of the mistakes made by standard 7 students while using geometric instruments. The purpose of action research is the improvement of the practice for betterment. Thus, the action research cycle has the 4 definite stages. The first one is the reflection. The researcher or the practitioner reflects on the present situation. He or she then plans an action for the improvement of the situation or solving the problem. After the plan is ready, then the practitioner actually acts according to that plan. After the plan is implemented, then the notings are taken, the observations are made as a result of the action. This resultant, the data is analyzed, and once again the researcher or the practitioner reaches the stage of reflection so as to see how far it has been successful. Now, when this reflection, planning, action and observation, when these 4 stages are completed, that means one cycle of action research is completed. After one such cycle of action research is completed, The researcher takes a review of the success or the failure of his change in the modality. Such cycles are continued further till the problem is solved to the 100%. And thus action research is a cyclic process that takes the journey in the further direction. We have seen the three types of researches based on the focus of the research. The three types were pure, applied and action researches. We have seen in detail about each of them sequentially. Now we will try to see them at one go. Here is a diagram of all the three researches showing their comparative scope. As you can see that the fundamental or basic pure researches, they form one repertoire in the researches. Whereas applied researches, they form another repertoire, and action research forms a smaller portion of these applied researches. As we have seen, applied researches, they have the objective of solving the problem of a larger group or a larger society. Whereas in case of action research, it is the solving of a problem that the practitioner faces in his or her daily life. And thus, you can see in this diagram how the three researches scope-wise are in relation with each other. We will see a few more differences in the three types. As we have seen that objective-wise the three differ, in case of pure researches, the objective is gaining knowledge for the knowledge sake, generating the theory. In case of applied researches, the utility of this theory is tested in the daily life. And in the third case, that is the action research, the researches are conducted in order to solve my problem, my situation. In case of action researches, the research is taken up for solving the single person's problem or the practitioner's problem. If we have to compare the three types in terms of the research situation, the pure researches, they are conducted in a laboratory kind of situation, which is more of an artificial situation. Applied researches are conducted into the social phenomena or in the daily real life situation. In case of action researches, also the researches are conducted in the daily life, but the situation is very, very specific to the practitioner. So thus, from the angle of the research situation, these three types also differ. From usability point of view, the pure researches, when they are conducted, one is not aware of their utility. One does not know where actually this theory will be used in society. In case of applied researches, yes, it has the immediate utility for a larger group of people. Even in case of action research, there is immediate utility, but it is limited to only one person, one group, or a specific group. We have seen three different types of researches depending on the purpose of taking up a research. The researcher has to make a choice from one of these types depending on his objective, and then the care has to be taken for following the steps that are required for that particular research. From pure research to action research, we have seen that the research from the laboratory situation has come gradually to the practitioner, and even a teacher in the classroom or a person who is working at a grassroots level can also take up the research. And maybe this is a motivation for the teachers for going up for the research. They don't need to go into the laboratory kind of a situation, but they can be involved in the research process even while they are practicing their profession.